Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Honorable presiding member, we are discussing the bill pertaining to reparations today. I'm glad the Honorable Minister of Foreign Affairs is in the House. This is as a result of the joint resolution that have been passed in the UN Human Rights Council and also previous undertakings that we have given under the Universal Periodic Review to address this issue of paying reparations for people who have been made to forcibly disappear and those people who have been affected by the war or any other civil disturbance. Mr. Presiding Member, I would like to initially discuss the matter pertaining to the repeal or the Repia Act by this Act. Now, as a matter of fact, the Honorable Foreign Minister had been a former Attorney General. He knows the whole history of the Repia Act. The Repia Act came into being, as a matter of fact, Mr. Presiding Member, after the 1983 disturbances, the then administration brought in the Repia through the emergency regulations that were promulgated to cover the entire island. So it was part of the emergency regulations initially, and thereafter in 1987, they formally legislated to make Repia as an authority with some legal status. And this Repia was an institution that not only looked at reparations to be paid to individuals and collective bodies of people, also to pay compensation for properties, to also restore properties, to take over properties, to vest the property. Now, as a matter of fact, after the 1983 disturbances, the then J.R. Jawadhan administration felt that there were various miscreants, various unlawful elements who are going into occupation of properties of affected people who had fled the city and other areas, and they vested the properties in the Repia. Now, by repealing Repia and by not providing adequate provisions in the new Act, we are doing away with an existing mechanism which provides certain relief at very, very difficult and emergency situations. Now, for instance, you had to bring transitional provisions. No, I don't know, but anyway, you can reply, Mr. Minister. What I felt was, now take for instance what happened in Kandy a few months ago. Now, there are several properties affected. Large number of properties in the Kandy district, starting from Digana to Akurana and various other areas, several properties were affected. The Repia is the authority which is looking into the compensation element. Now, as a matter of fact, I want to raise that issue here so that that will be brought to the notice of the Honorable Minister. I have raised it several times in Cabinet. There are about 80 files for which more than 500,000 rupees had to be paid as compensation. There are sometimes some properties have been damaged, certain people have lost their businesses amounting to several millions of rupees. Now, these assessments have still not been completed, and a proper cabinet assessment has not been done to pay compensation for them. The Repia is the institution that is tasked with the responsibility to pay this compensation. So if we are going to abolish that institution, then there has to be sufficient new provisions should be included in the new Act which we are bringing to replace the Repia as an institution. That is one issue I want to raise with you, Honorable Minister. Okay, thank you very much. I think there is a provision for you to formulate some policies and formulate policies on reparation and recommend to the government for approval and thereafter for cabinet to approve them. See, in that, at least through that process, to include whatever that is missing from the Repia Act onto this reparations bill would be a very necessary thing that you should implement. Now, I must also say, now this focuses on the missing persons. Actually, the The Office on Missing Persons Act is referred to several times in this particular bill, and that this is a sequel to that act. So therefore, Office on Missing Persons, when they identify affected people, people who have been made to disappear, people who have been who had gone missing as a result of the war, as a result of various other agencies of government or any other individual agencies. So those victims of war or civil disturbances, reparations could be paid through this bill. But then affected properties and affected other entitlements may not be restored through such a bill. So there has to be a proper provision to look into that issue, and that I thought I should highlight here. Now, Office on Missing Persons have been in existence for the last 7 months, Mr. Minister. They have gone over the country, all over the place, had various public sittings, and have received applications from a variety of affected people. Victims have still are continuing to have some distrust in any government mechanism that will, whether that would ultimately bring them any relief. That has been the feeling that people have. So therefore, in the first place, we had to restore that confidence. Now, for instance, as the Honorable Foreign Minister, as a former Attorney General, is also aware, in the past...
Honorable Minister, you've got 2 minutes.
Yes. In the past, our practice, Honorable Sumandran is here, if people go missing, only recourse we have is habeas corpus application in the Court of Appeal then. What does the Court of Appeal do? I have myself filed these habeas corpus applications. Nothing comes out of it. You file a habeas corpus application by an aggrieved party, court entertains it, and they refer it to a magistrate for inquiry. And that's the end of it. The Honorable Foreign Minister will endorse this as Attorney General. He must be having hundreds of thousands of files in his in the Attorney General's department, habeas corpus applications, without any finality. So this issue, hopefully, at least through this Office on Missing Persons and the Reparations Bill, hopefully all these victims, some kind of finality for their loss have to be brought about, and at least some reparation that be paid. So this is an onerous duty that is cast on the members who are appointed to these two institutions. One is the Reparations Bill as well as the Office on Missing Persons. So I thought I must highlight some of these things. And now look at the issue that is happening in Mena. There is a mass grave that has been found. There are anthropologists, there are archaeologists, there are various others, forensic experts who are going and digging this mass grave. There was a mass grave that was found in Matale. What has come out of the investigation, God knows. When did this happen? Was it during the JVP insurrection, or was it during the LTT war, or was it some, they are also
Honorable
giving
Minister,
some...
Honorable Minister, please wind up.
Yeah, there are certain excuses being trotted out to say that there was some serious health hazard that happened in that area, and therefore thousands of people could have been buried in such a fashion. I don't think anybody remembers such a incident happening anywhere in this country. But this has to be gone into. What is happening in the Matale graves? What is happening in the Mana graves? These two issues, I think, is a matter for anybody with conscience, that we have to bring finality to these things. So forensic examinations and inquiries cannot go on forever without any closure. So some closure has to be brought to this, and I would rather urge through you, Mr. Presiding Member, that this bill and its impact on this country as an accountable international citizen should clear its name by bringing such bills and acts to give redress to the affected
Honorable
people.
Minister.
Thank you.
Thanks. Garu Bimal Ratnayake Mantuma.
Garu Amantuma, Abutuma, Hakeem Amantuma, Abutuma Cabinet Take Amati Varek Vashin, Madanagana Kamati, then Mannarama Samuha Minivalagan Abutuma Prakashak Kalamitana, then he Kanimbar of Hitapu, Raj Somadeva Mahachara Varayage Kanimbalapatra. මගේ දැනීමේ හැටියට දැනට අත්හිටවා තිබෙනවා.
ගරු මන්තුමා
ඒ නිසා මම දැනගන්න කැමති කැබිනට් මණ්ඩලය වශයෙන් mukadda me sambandha karanne kiyala mukadda metana danata 154 ak atasakili aathmaham bela thibena
nena man nan mata nan aranchi wena hatiyata e kanim wala e atasakili e eke carbon dating sandaha americanu laboratory ekata yawanta thirne karala thibunai kiyala thama man dakke e carbon dating eka uda thamai e kavadada siduune මොන වගේ සිද්ධියද කියන එක පිළිබඳව ඒකේ නිගමනයකට එන්න පුළුවන්කමක් ලැබෙන්නේ කියලා මේ මම පත්තරවල දැක්කා.
හරි බොහොම
ස්තුතියි. නමුත් අමාත්‍යවරයෙක් හැටියට මම ඔබතුමා කියන කාරණා දැන් තමයි දන්නේ. මම හිතන්නේ මේ හැටියට ඒකට ඕනනම් අපේ ඇමතුමා පිළිතුරු දෙයි විදේශ ඇමතුමා හැටියට මන්නම් ඒ ගැන කිසි කාරණයක් දන්නේ නැහැ.
හරි බොහොම ස්තුතියි ඇමතුමා.